Okay, good morning everyone. Now it is on page
good morning, ma'am.
46, right? And we were on the third para. We had done the third para. I explained you the third para.
Good morning, ma'am.
See, fertility falls as income rise. This I explained it.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Stress and health improves. Thus, development is the best contraceptive, but development itself may not be possible if the present increase in number continues. Up till here, I had explained. Did I explain or not? Yes, the answer should come out at once.
Yes, ma'am.
So, what is the meaning of this para? Who will tell me? What did you understand from this?
Ma'am, means the development is the best solution for the declining of the earth.
For declining of
health.
The earth?
Okay. Ma'am,
the earth will
ma'am, for declining of the environment. No, ma'am. Ma'am, then? I am saying that earth, environment of the earth is badly affected.
Right.
Ma'am,
now,
the development is the best solution.
Okay, we are talking about the environment, but later on many problems have been raised in this chapter, okay? And the most important problem that has been raised in this chapter is about the population increase, okay? So it has been said that as a person gets educated, he or she will be more educated. Then what will happen? Lot of development will be there. Lot of work to do. Many jobs will be there. And he would understand the ill effects of large families having more than two children. He will surely understand the ill effects, okay, of having many children. And definitely he is going to have either one or two children and going to just divert all his attention towards them only. And as soon as a person gets educated, surely he will do it. He will have smaller families and the health of the family, it will be improved. The economic condition will be developed, okay? And lot of development will be there in the country and on this earth. But writer says the development may not be possible if the population rise continues in this manner. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Everybody?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
See now what happens. The rich get richer and the poor beget children which condemn them to remain poor. This is happening or not? The world population is increasing and the rich people, they are becoming richer day by day. And the poor people, you know, they are giving birth to children and these children, you know, they are condemned. You know, they have to remain poor. Why? Lot of children is there in the family and only earning souls is either the father or mother, yeah, both of them, that, and still then they are not able to fulfill the needs of their children. See, what does the writer say? More children does not mean more workers, merely more people without work. Got it or not? What happens? The poor people think that if we will give birth to many children, good, they are going to earn for us. Hamare liye kamayenge. They do not understand that more children does not mean more workers. Instead, more mouth to feed. Isn't it? More people will increase without work. Got it or not?
Yes, ma'am.
They think ki hamare zyada bachche honge to zyada kama ke layenge, par aisa nahi hota beta. Zyada kahan se kamayenge? Zyada khane wale bhi to ho jayenge. Hai na? Unemployment bhi to badh jayega. Why? Why all these thoughts come into the mind? Because they are not so educated. Clear? Yadi educated hote, so they would have come to know the these demerits or disadvantages of having more than two children. Okay, whatever two or one children gets, it would be divided among 6 or 8 or 10 children, whatever, isn't it? So very meager these children are going to get, and the family, it will remain poor as always. Clear or not?
Yes, ma'am.
It is not suggested that human beings be treated like cattle and compulsorily sterilized up. It does not mean that human beings, you know, they should be treated like cattle. Right? Remember this, more population means more unemployment. The writer wants to tell us. Okay, and human beings, they should not be treated like cattle and who are sterilized by force. They should be treated like human beings only. But there is no alternative to voluntary family planning without introducing an element of coercion. Coercion means force, write down. Force. But the writer says, now here the writer says that we should not treat human beings like cattle and by force we should sterilize them. But again he says, then there is no alternative to volunteer family planning. Volunteer means willing. Willing, you got it? Apni ichcha se. Isliye it is very necessary to introduce an element of coercion, means it is very necessary to introduce some element of force. It has to be put on family planning by the government, then only the population would be in control. The choice is really between control of population and perpetuation, means continuation. Write the meaning, continuation of poverty. Okay, now human beings, the writer says, human beings, you know, they are responsible. They have to choose, either they want to increase the population or they want to have control on poverty. Okay, it all depends on the choice of human beings. What should be chosen? What should be chosen? Control of population or perpetuation or continuation of poverty, what should be chosen, children?
Man first.
Yes.
Control of population.
Yes, good. Understood this, para?
Yes, ma'am.
Everybody? Yes, ma'am. Okay.
Yes,
the
ma'am.
Population yes, of ma'am. India is estimated to be 920 million today. Okay. That was in the year when? 1994 it was, na? When this article was written. Which year it was? 1994? Isn't it? So at the yes, time, sir. The writer says, at that time it was calculated that the population of a country, it was 920 million, na? More than the entire populations of Africa and South America put together. Got it? More than the population of Africa and South America together. Dono ki population mila kar bhi. Us samay bhi India ki population bahut zyada thi. 920 million. Aur uske baad se to it has increased up to a great extent. No one familiar with the conditions in India would doubt that the hope of the people would die in the hungry hutments unless population control is given topmost priority. Okay, if the population of India is not controlled, the writer says, most of the people, most of the population of India will die in their huts having a hope in their heart. They will never be better. They will never enjoy a better life. Clear? If the population of India wouldn't be controlled, then many, many of the people, he says, will die in their huts just having a hope in their hearts. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
For the first time in human history, we see a transcending concern. Transcending concern kya hota hai? A concern that existed from a long time and now it passes from one generation to another. Okay, you can write down a concern. Concern kya hoti? Chinta. Kaafi samay se thi wo chinta. Lekin ab generation to generation it is passing on. Now even likewise, if the grandparents, they were worried about the earth, similarly now the son is worried about the earth and then his son. So this concern, this worry, this anxiety, it is passing on from one generation to another. Write down the meaning. Concern existed for a long time and has passed from one generation to another. Okay, so writer कहते हैं for the first time in human history हम देखते हैं transcending concern means people are now very much concerned about the survival of Mother Earth, about this planet. The survival not just of the people but of the planet. Okay, they are concerned not about themselves but they are very much concerned about the environment, about the planet, about the Mother Earth. They want to save Mother Earth. We have begun to take a holistic view of the very basis of our existence. The environmental problem does not necessarily signal our device. Okay? Aap kehte hain, we have now started to see our existence, a comprehensive view, a holistic view se hum dekhne lage, ek ecological view se hum dekhne lage. ओके एनवायरमेंटल प्रॉब्लम का ये मतलब नहीं है कि हमारा डिमाइस होने वाला है ना, ये कोई सिग्नल नहीं है हमारे डिमाइस का. डिमाइस इज डेथ का. समझ में आया क्या है ये? इट इज अ पासपोर्ट फॉर द फ्यूचर. गॉट इट? बल्कि एक ये पासपोर्ट है फॉर द फ्यूचर, यानी सॉल्विंग एनवायरमेंटल प्रॉब्लम, यू नो इट इज अ काइंड ऑफ अ पासपोर्ट दैट विल टेक अस टू द फ्यूचर एंड शुड नॉट बी सीन एज अ साइन ऑफ अ डेथ. द राइटर वॉन्ट्स टू से दिस. ओके, कि दे जो एनवायरमेंटल प्रॉब्लम है, इट शुड नॉट बी सीन एज अ डिमाइस, एज अ डेथ, रादर इट शुड बी सीन, ओके, टू सॉल्व दिस प्रॉब्लम इट शुड बी सीन दैट इट इज अ पासपोर्ट दैट विल टेक अस टू अ सेफ फ्यूचर इफ द एनवायरमेंटल प्रॉब्लम इट गेट्स सॉल्व. क्लियर?
यस मैम.
यस मैम.
ओके. द एमर्जिंग न्यू वर्ल्ड विजन हैज अशर्ड इन द एरा ऑफ रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी. नाउ द एमर्जिंग न्यू वर्ल्ड विजन. ओके, पीपल यू नो दे आर हैविंग दिस विजन, दे आर हैविंग दिस ड्रीम that a new world where the environment would be good, okay, where the planet would be healthy, right? It has ushered in the era of responsibility. In this era, in this period of responsibility, okay, a vision of new world has been seen. Vision is a dream. It is a holistic view, an ecological view. Seeing the world as an integrated whole means seeing the world as one, okay, rather than a disassociated collection of parts and not as different parts. Okay, everybody should see the world as a single unit, as a single planet. Okay, rather than seeing as a disassociated parts. Okay, disassociated means different parts. Like you say, India, I just want to save India. Others say, I just want to save my country. No. We have to see it as a single unit, as a single part. Okay, the whole earth, you know, it is one, it is an integrated whole. We don't have to divide it. We have to be concerned about the whole planet, about the whole earth. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, industry has the most crucial role to play in this new era of era. You got it? In this period of responsibility, industries, they play a very important role in this period of responsibility. Water transformation would be affected if more businessmen share. Transformation means change. Kitna change aayega yadi businessmen, they share the view of the chairman of DuPont, Mr. Edgar S. Bullard, who 5 years ago declared himself to be the company's chief environmental officer. So now in this era of responsibility towards the environment, okay, industries, they play a very important role, and chairman of DuPont, Mr. Woolard, declared himself as the chief environmental officer, and he said, a continued existence as a leading manufacturer requires that we excel in environmental profession. Okay, that he just declared that a continued existence. Okay, if we want to exist in this world and we want to be a leading manufacturer, who is a manufacturer? One who makes something, okay, one who produces something, right? So if we want to be very, very good manufacturer and excellent manufacturer, then we have to excel. We have to be excellent in environment performance. Samajh mein aa gaya? Environment ko bahut achha produce karna hai. Got it or not? The main duty, the first duty, yadi aap samajhte hain ki aap bahut achhe manufacturer hain, to sabse pehle kya manufacture karna hai? The best environment for this planet, for this earth. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Everybody?
Yes,
yes,
ma'am.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Of all the statements made by Margaret Thatcher during the years of her prime ministership, none has passed so decisively into the current coin of English usage as her felicitous words. See, what did Margaret Thatcher the other day when I explained you the summary? I told you that Margaret Thatcher, who was then the prime minister of England, okay, what did she say? No generation has a freehold on this earth. Freehold, you got it? What is it? Freehold is permanent tenure. Okay, permanent tenure of land or property means a full control. You can write down the meaning. Permanent tenure of land or property or a free hold means full control on this earth. Okay, so she said that no human being on this earth, she or he, holds a permanent tenure. He is not the only sole master. He is not the only master on this earth. All we have is a life tenancy. Tenancy, I got you. We have to live as a tenant. Tenant means as a rented person, we have to live on this earth with a full repairing lease. Okay, hame kaise rehna hai? Kiraydar ki tarah rehna hai. Hame ye nahi samajhna hai. We are the masters of this earth, children. Okay, and as a tenant, we have to live on this earth. Jiska ek contract signed hota hai ki if anything damages, okay, if you are a tenant. Okay, if you are living as a tenant, samajh gaye, kiraydar ki tarah, if you are living somewhere, so a deal is signed between you and the landowner ki if anything is being damaged in the house, then this is a lease, this is a contract that you are going to get it repaired. So similarly, Margaret Thatcher ne bahut achhe words kahe the ki hame aise rehna as if we are living as a tenant, and if any damage is done to this mother earth, we are responsible to repair it. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
And in the words of Mr. Lester Brown, aur unhone to bahut khoobsurat baat kahi thi, a very wonderful thing was spoken by Mr. Lester Brown. He says, we have not inherited this earth from our forefathers, we have borrowed it from our children. समझ में आया बेटा कि यदि हम ये सोच रहे हैं ना कि we have not inherited, okay, this is not a parental property, we have not inherited from our ancestors, right? We have to think we have borrowed it from our children, we have borrowed it from our next generation, from our future generation. Then only we will be able to save Mother Earth. Then only we will be able to save it. Okay. Save the planet, we will be able to intact it. Got it or not? See?
Yes, ma'am.
If you get something from your parents, you hardly care for it. But if you borrow something from other person, okay, you care it a lot, you know, you are very much this thing concerned about the thing, okay? Ki wo cheez jo hai, it should not be lost, it should not be broken. And jaise aapne liye, the way you have taken from the person, the way you have borrowed it from the person, similarly, you are going to return it as a whole, right? Usko acche se hai na, puri tarike se aap return karoge. Okay, so similarly, Lester R. Brown ne bhi ye kaha hai ki we don't have to think ki ye jo earth hai, we have inherited from our parents, from our ancestors, from our forefathers. We have to think ki this earth, we have borrowed it from our generations, from our children, from our next generation, from our future generation, and we have to return it back, okay, without harming it, without breaking it, without destroying it. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Everybody?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, fine, beta. Any problems?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Sure? No, ma'am.
Okay, okay, fine. Okay, it's time also. You take care, okay?
Thank you, ma'am.
Goodbye, beta. Saturday
Thank
and
you,
Sundays
ma'am.
Are off. Okay, Saturday and Sundays.
Thank you, ma'am.
5 days are off. Thank you very much, children. God bless you a lot.